Nelson Preston.
Madam Speaker, I move that the bill entitled the Poverty Reduction and Economic Inclusion Act, of which notice has been given in my name on the order paper, be introduced and read a first time now.
Honourable members, you've heard the question. All those in favour?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion is carried. Member?
Madam Speaker, today marks the fifth time the New Democrat opposition has introduced this legislation. Since 2011, when we first introduced a bill for a poverty reduction plan, we have seen food bank use in BC increase, housing costs, food costs, hydro rates, and post-secondary education costs increase as well. We have also seen every other province adopt plans that tackle poverty and seek economic inclusion for every one of their citizens. BC now remains the only province without a legislated plan that is transparent and accountable to its citizens. If we had a plan, government would have the structure in place to know when they are about to make poverty-creating policies and avoid such detrimental actions. For example, had BC passed this bill already, it is highly unlikely that government would have suggested a bus pass clawback that increases bus pass fees for people with disabilities living in poverty. Additionally, a Poverty Reduction and Economic Inclusion Act, as enabled by this act, would task government with identifying poverty-creating policies that are already in place and seek to end them. An example here is the maternity and parental leave clawbacks that deny working people with disabilities their right to collect EI benefits for maternity and parental leaves from work. While other Canadians have this right, our current government is denying them it, and it plunges families further into poverty simply because they are having children. There are so many factors that contribute to poverty, and ignoring poverty costs our communities and our economy more than taking action with a real plan. Because of this, and because it is the right thing to do, we need a comprehensive plan with targets and timelines to do the meaningful work of reducing poverty and including everyone in our economy. Today, this Poverty Reduction and Economic Inclusion Act can do just that, only if we're given the opportunity to debate and pass it. Madam Speaker, I move that this bill be placed on the orders of the day for the second reading at the next sitting of this House after today.